Hey yo, Wagwan, my beautiful people. Xyan coming at you again with another tutorial. Now this one is a request and this one is entitled We And Dem by Robert Nesta Marley, popular known as Bob Marley. Now, before we get into the tutorial, before we get into anything, I'm just going to ask you all to just go ahead and hit the subscribe button down there, hit the notification bell, and also whenever I post a new video, whenever I post, you will be notified. You'll be the first to know. And also, hit the thumbs up button. I promise, there's no spikes on it. It won't hurt. Don't be shy. Hit it. Hit it now, man. Before I forget, I just want to let you folks know that for copyright reasons, and this is for most of the people that have been complaining that I'm not playing out the whole song. For copyright reasons, I will not be playing out the whole song in any of the videos, right? If you do not know the structure of the songs, I implore you to go ahead and listen to the originals, right? I'll be leaving a link to this original in the description. Go ahead and check that out also. You'll find a lot of other links or stuff that you can, you know, check out and other videos that I, you know, think you'll probably be interested in. Without any further ado, this is how you play Bob Marley's We and Them on electric guitar. Grab yours. Let's go. Alright, my people, so now for this song I will be carefully going through the sections, right? We have bridge, chorus, verse, we also have stock lines, and we have a few little licks, you know, that I'm going to be demonstrating, I'm going to be showing you folks. Alright, so pay attention. Alright, undivided attention. Right, so again, if you do not know the structure of the song, go ahead and listen to it, then come back here and, you know, and get it. Right, so for the intro starts on the 3. So here's a demonstration. Then it goes to the 2. We all know how we and them are going to work it out. You stay there. We don't know how we and them are going to work it out. Then you move to the 3. 6. 4, 5. As you can hear, that is the verse. So that was the intro, the chorus, and the verse. All right, so I'm going to be going slow. So now let me just deal with the cards. All right, first, so the first card for the intro, that's going to be the B minor. So you can use this one, right, which is a 9th fret. Or you can use this one on the 3rd fret. Alright, so let's use the 9th fret. Right, because most people is, you know, are going to want to use this. Right, but funny enough, when I play it here. So should I just go ahead and show my way? I think I should. I think I should. So let's bar the old 2nd fret and let's place the middle finger on the 2nd fret. The 2nd string, 3rd fret. Pinky finger on the 3rd string, 4th fret, ring finger on the 4th string, 4th fret. So you stay there for the intro. And you will hear the changes. Then you move to the 2. No, oh, and them I go work it out. So that two right there, you're going to bar the whole 5th fret. You want to place that ring finger on the 5th string, 7th fret. Pinky finger on the 4th string, 7th fret. So, no, 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 oh, we and them, I go work it out. We no, 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 oh, we and them, I go work it out. Someone will have to pay. Right, so that's, you go back to the that B minor right there, which was the first card. Then you're going to play an E minor. That E minor, of course you can play this one right here. But let's use this one. Because I'm showing you folks how to keep everything there so you don't have to move all over the neck of the guitar right now. Right, so this one you want to bar the second fret with the pointer finger. You want to place the middle finger on the first string, third fret. Ring finger goes on the fourth string, no, the third string, fourth fret. Pinky finger on the second string, fifth fret. So you play E minor, no, my bad, B minor, E minor. Now you're going to play a C major. To get the C major, bar the whole third fret, place that ring finger on the second, third, and fourth string of the fifth fret. So far. Someone will have to pay. C major. Now you're gonna go to D major. And this D major, you just wanna go a hole up. So now the pointer finger is going to be barring the fifth string, right? The fifth fret, my bad. Alright, so here we go. You continue playing that. Now you are going to be hearing that. That pause on the E minor. Then a D major, C major. So this is how it goes. Back to the two. We know how we and them I go work it out. So the chorus is just the chorus is just the A minor. Alright. So that takes care of the intro, the verse, and the chorus. Now again, if you do not know the structure of the song, listen to it. And this will be very easy. Alright. You don't try to learn this and then go to the original. It wouldn't make any sense, right? So once you know the song, then this will be perfect. This will be easy for you. All right, and that's basically it for the intro, the verse. Intro, the chorus, and the verse. That's basically it. All right, so you're following. So that's it for the chords. Let's move to the stock line. Okay. So for the stock line, right? A stock line is a guitar line that accompanies a bass line. So 95% of the time, whatever the bass plays is what the guitar is going to play in a higher register or sometimes the same. All right? So for this stock line, the chorus will be... Or you can play it in a lower register. But you have to be quicker on the thicker string because it's, you know. For the verse. Not my bad. The stock line for the chorus, I'm going to be showing you folks that right now. I'm not going to be calling out the notes, but I'm going to be playing it as slow as possible so you folks can, you know, I want you folks to follow. Listen and follow. Here we go. Thank you. Let me go slower. Continue with that. With a groove. Now if you want to play it here, it's going to be an open E. That's the stock line for the chorus. Now the stock line for the chorus. Some people are going to call it the bridge, but the chorus. All right? So it goes like this. Again, I'm going to be playing it slow. So here's a demonstration first. Slow. It might be a little bit longer than that, but that's basically what you play over and over until you get to that, until you exit. All right, that's basically it for the stock line. All right, the part that I'm sure a lot of people are excited about, right, which is very simple. Lick number one, when it goes, we don't know how we and them are gonna work it, you know. Now you have people that play it many different ways, right? But here's my way. Here's the closest, easiest way for you folks. All right, sometimes when I'm on stage, I get a little bit crazy and I start doing some stuff, all right? Some stuff like that. But remember, we're just dealing with the original first. So here we go. We don't know how we and them are gonna work. So let's use that one. All right, so what we're playing right there, we're going to come all the way up here to the 7th fret. You want to, it's the 1st and 2nd string. So 1 down, up, up, all right? Then. So. So. Down, up, up, down. Down. Down, up. All right, so. Again. So now this is the first two string, my bad. Then you're gonna switch, right? And you wanna place the pointer finger on the second string of the 8th fret. Place that ring finger on the first string, 9th fret. All right, so you're gonna get switch back to the 7th fret. Then you wanna do two downs and up. So here we go, slow. The second time around it goes. So down, up, up, down, down. Down, up, up, down. Switch, one down, switch back, another down. That's basically it. So we don't know how we and them are gonna work it out. We don't know how we and them are gonna work it. Do 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 You know, so, you know, exaggerating a little bit right there. So, that's it for lick number one. So, lick number two, you are mostly going to be hearing this whenever you're exiting the verse. All right? And it goes like this. My bad. All right? Like that. Alright, so what I play right there is, so let me call this out for you folks, all the way up here to the 12th fret 2nd string, my bad, 12th fret 2nd string, then 3rd string. Same 12th fret. Then you move to this, the 11th fret, 3rd string. Then 10th fret, 4th string. So far you got. First part. You want to move to the 2nd string, 10th fret. Then you move to the same 2nd string, same 2nd string, but this time 8th fret. So. Now, 9th fret, 3rd string. Then, 10th fret, 4th string. So you get. My bad. So, jump back to the 8th fret 2nd string, hammer on to the 10th fret 2nd string. And that would be the first one. Now, when it moves to the part where it's going to be ta-da-dip-ta-da-ta-da, you know? Now, same thing. You stop there. What I play there, I'm going to be playing it slow. Alright, so again. Then you want to pick up at the 10th fret 2nd string. This one is different. First one was. Second one. So two different. Okay. My bad, I messed up right there, but you know, that's basically. Thank you. them I go work it out. And that is basically it for the licks. And that is basically it for the whole song. Now, as for the strumming is simple. It's just one skank down. Right? One skank, you know. We no know how we and them I go work it out. Now, as for the tuning of my guitar, it's just a little bit of reverb. That's all. Right? My guitar is clean. Now, for that song, right, I do believe they use a bit of phaser. So when you listen to it, you're going to hear that. All right? I chose to do the tutorial without any form of effects, really, because I want it to be clear. You know, I want clarity. I want you folks to really hear what's going on right there and not just the effects. I don't want anybody concentrating on the effects and, you know, whatever I'm using. So just clean tone. Clean guitar. Anything funny you hear, that's the finger, that's a skill. So as for the strumming, remember as you squeeze, you release almost instantly. You release the pressure, but you keep the fingers there just to kill the sound. So you can get that staccato feel. Of course, if you want to add your little bit of slide, you can do so. All right, but it was just mainly about the chords, the stock line, and the licks. All right. So, my name is Xyan. Remember to subscribe to the channel. Remember to hit the thumbs up button on all of my videos. I know this one was easy. I know this one was helpful. In the meantime, blessed love. Peace out. Keep strumming. Keep practicing. See you next time.